I'm Lucy Davies and I'm an aerospace engineer at BAE Systems and I studied aeronautical engineering at Loughborough University. Okay, so I kind of went into engineering because at first in school I really enjoyed maths, the sciences, particularly physics. And I remember really clearly, like, we were in primary school, so I was probably about 8 years old. We went to a power plant on a school trip, and first of all, one of their machines was called Lucy. So obviously being 8 years old, I was like, my name's Lucy, it's meant to be. That kind of just showed me that obviously women can be engineering, opened that kind of visibility for me. And then like I said, because I really enjoyed the maths and physics, it always just kind of stayed with me. But that trip was, yeah, a real highlight to me, and it kind of also showed me how much engineering and STEM as a whole kind of underpins everything we do. So whilst at university, I did a number of internships. So I did a summer internship after my second year at Caterpillar. So I moved over to Belfast and did manufacturing engineering. Then after my third year, I did a year internship at BAE Systems. And that was then in systems engineering. And then finally, I kind of came after completing university onto the BAE Systems graduate scheme. And now I'm an integration engineer. So I think that also shows how you can do all different types of engineering as well, not just specifically what you do within your degree. So for me, actually, the thing I enjoy the most is also the thing that sometimes is the biggest challenge, and it's the people. So the people, obviously, as I work within integration, I get to speak to so many people. That's obviously a key part of integration, is integrating all the different areas of a platform. And I love being able to kind of get everyone's different viewpoints, different kind of mindsets, backgrounds, understanding, and pulling it all together, but also building your network and seeing kind of what's really out there. I love that. But sometimes with integration, you're kind of pulling together everyone's different viewpoints, and as they're all different, we can get pushback, sometimes there can be blockers, but being able to kind of take that step back and like see why everyone thinks this way, why there are blockers, that's how we come up with kind of solutions together as a team. So three issues I'd say would be sustainability is a big one. Obviously, we know this is a global problem that we're all working together, every industry, and aviation is a huge one. So we need to decarbonise our aircraft. Within STEM, we have a big skills shortage. So the UK STEM workforce is growing, and we've got more jobs faster than like we can recruit. So there's this growing kind of skills shortage. And then another one would just be, for me, underrepresentation. So although our STEM landscapes are changing, and they are changing dramatically, we are still very underrepresented, especially on gender and ethnicity. But I think we can pull all these together when we look at bringing a more diverse workforce. We get new innovative solutions for sustainability. We are closing that workforce and skills gap, and we're getting more representation. So a really big one is teamwork. We are very collaborative in engineering. There's nothing that can be solved by just one person. So that kind of ties in with the teamwork, the collaboration, problem solving. Obviously that underpins what engineering is. We solve problems. I think sometimes we create problems so we can solve them. So it is a really big one. And then communication is another really big one. Yeah, so I think lots of people think working in STEM, you're going to go in and it's going to be full of men and in greasy overalls, and that's just not the case. Every day I go in and I wear heels, I've got acrylic nails, you know, it's not like that anymore. And also there's a big difference between engineers and technicians, and engineering now it's so clean. So obviously we have everything called like FOD, which is foreign objects debris. So you can't have any FOD, you work in aircraft hangar, it's really clean, it's pristine, it's not men in greasy overalls. I'd say just go for it. There's so many opportunities, there's so many different things you can do, and just ask lots of questions. There's no such thing as a silly question, and there's always someone else in the room that's thinking it, so don't be afraid to ask questions. So one that was given to me, and I really take it forward, is to be flexible. So when I was in high school, I thought I had to have this really rigid career path that I was going to take me from here to here, and I had to do that and nothing else. But actually, being flexible, it allows you to explore what opportunities there are.